Richard, when did you first start playing the piano?
Well, I started when I was very young, when I was 5 or 6. And it was a pleasure for me to sit in front of the piano and to play. And my father was a piano teacher, and it helped me a lot.
So, you then went from having a little play of the piano to being a superstar. Tell me, how did that happen?
Well, you know, after to study classical music, you know, I started to play with friends, musicians, and after I started to play in studio, and after I met my producers, and I met Olivier Toussaint, Paul de Senneville, and I started my first record.
Tell me about that.
Well, do you mean my first single? Yes, my first single was Ballad for Adeline, and I recorded it in 1976, and it was a big hit in Spain, in Europe, and after in South America, Australia, New Zealand, and Japan, all around the world.
And how surprised were you about that?
Yes, because, you know, for example, I didn't want to be a classical pianist, and I was very happy when I was an accompanist for different French singers, for example. And to record my first melodies, it was, for me, very good, very nice. And but I must say that I was very surprised because, you know, this melody is very quiet, very nice. And I must say that I'm very lucky.
So what do you think it is that makes your music so popular?
Maybe it is because my way of playing the piano, my repertoire, and once again, my personality. You know, I'm a very quiet person, and it's always for me a pleasure to play very nice melodies. And I think people need this kind of music.
Where do you get your inspiration from? What sort of music do you like? I mean, tell me about that.
Well, of course, I enjoy very much listening to classical music. Because when I was young, I started with classical music, but now I enjoy very much listening to, for example, melodies by Paul McCartney or John Lennon or Paul Young or Barbara Streisand. There are a lot of very good singers.
What about heavy metal, things like that?
Not really, no. I don't like it too much.
How do you classify yourself, though? It's very difficult to define you, either pop or classical.
I think I am between classical and popular music, but it's difficult to find a good word for this kind of music.
How do you decide which pieces you're going to do?
Well, it's always a work between my managers and my record company, and always we try to find very nice melodies, very good melodies, very well-known melodies, and original melodies, such like Ballad for Adeline, Letter to My Mother, Hell for Love, for example.
Now, when you do melodies that other people have written, do you ever get any reaction from those artists?
Do you mean another artist? It depends. Sometimes, for example, I met lots of very good singers who told me we like your music, and it's nice. It's a nice reward for me.
And when you finished a piece of music by another singer, for example, do you send them it to listen to it?
No, because I'm very shy, you know, I prefer to keep with me.
How much time do you spend touring?
Well, it's about 6 months a year, and I used to do lots of concerts and all around the world, And after, when I am at home, I have to practice, I have to prepare new recordings, to do lots of promotion in every country. So it's a lot of work.
How many records do you release a year?
It's between 4 and 5 or 6. Because, for example, this year I have recorded an album for your country, for England, and another one for Italy, another one for France.
That's a huge amount, isn't it?
Yes.
So how much of practicing or work do you have to do every day?
Every day I try to practice 2-3-4 hours. Every day, every day. And I feel better.